Dr. Lemoncelli, Dallas, what's the difference between a Luminia and a Venia? We hear a lot about it. They both seem to be, you know, in the end effect, relatively doing the same thing. They seem to be like a fingernail clip-on, you know, which makes the tooth look nicer, better, and whatever. But there seems to be lots of, you know, questions, controversial and dark, about Luminius versus Venius. Dallas.
Well, veneer means anything that goes over the face of a tooth. Many years ago, they first started out as plastic or composite type veneers. And it was found that over a period of years, there's a question of durability for this particular type of restoration. It would chip, it would discolor, and it's pretty much fallen by the wayside. Not too many dentists do the composite or plastic veneers anymore, especially on the front teeth. The Lumineers are porcelain laminate veneers, and Lumineers is a brand name. It's the Denmat Corporation's brand of porcelain laminate veneers. They were one of the first ones to come out with it. And they really give you a Hollywood smile. For patients that have perfectly healthy teeth, but they don't like the color, for whatever the reason, they might have tetracycline staining, which causes the teeth to become very gray, and their attempts at bleaching the teeth haven't been successful, and they've never been happy with the color. Sometimes they don't like the shape of their teeth, and there might be little spaces between the front teeth. This can all be corrected with porcelain laminate veneers. And that's pretty much what is done at the current time. Porcelain laminate veneers can really rehabilitate a smile.
So is a porcelain laminate veneer, is that a Luminia?
Yes, it is.
It is.
Like I say, Luminia is the brand name of the porcelain laminate veneer that the Denmat Corporation creates.
So I, you know, I've heard that, for instance, a what is maybe the old way or just another way, I don't know, the veneers, you have to grind down the tooth quite a bit, and then you basically glue that fingernail on it, you know, to glue that veneer on it. And where with the Luminia, which is the brand out of Denmark or the Denmark Corporation, I don't know if it's from the country of Denmark, that one is, you don't have to grind the tooth down because apparently it's a little bit thinner. So you don't need an injection for one, meaning the Luminia, and yet you need one for the veneer. Is that true or am I off here?
No, that's true. If the teeth have a lot of spacing or require a lot of correction, then they may have to be reduced a little bit in order to do the porcelain laminate veneer to make it as aesthetic as possible. But there are no prep Lumineers, which are simply put on over the face of the teeth with a bonding material, which is set by a high-intensity light. It's light-cured. And all that's required is a simple impression of the mouth. It's sent to the laboratory. The laboratory makes it, and when it comes back, it's put on to the teeth with composite adhesive material. And there's no injections or anything else with that.
Okay. Is there a time where the Luminia, no injection, just putting it on, no grinding down the teeth, where it is inappropriate, not fitting, and the other way of grinding the tooth and putting on the normal veneer is more suitable?
Yes. When there is a lot of correction that's required. In other words, if the teeth are out of alignment, if they're flared out labially, or they're very crooked and they require a lot of work, then the teeth have to be prepared and reduced and ground down a little bit so that when the lumineers are made, it looks more aesthetic. Naturally, if they're spaces because of missing teeth, then probably the only way to address that is either with bridge work or with implants. So you get into different types of treatment, you know, which has to be customized to the patient's individual needs. But lumineers are made mostly to do minor corrections and correct the shade of the teeth.
Okay. So what about if one tooth is chipped? You know, say I have pretty good teeth, they are like them, everything is fine, but then I go and crack that one tooth. What would be the method of fixing that one? Because it shouldn't then, if you glue on aluminium, no matter what, that tooth got to become a little bit bigger than it was before, or will it be first grinded down? So is it possible to fix just one tooth in front, or do you always need a whole row of veneers or lumineers?
No, provided the other teeth are in their proper alignment and they look aesthetic, it's possible to do just one tooth. You know, of course, it has to be evaluated on an individual basis. If the fracture is very, very big, probably the best way to deal with that is to make a crown or a cap to go over the tooth, and then the tooth will look just like the other teeth. If it's a very minor thing, then a lumineer or a porcelain laminate might be acceptable.
Okay. Well, wonderful. Thanks a lot. I think that should give us an idea of what this is all about. Or do you think you need to add something to it?
I think that pretty much covers it. Like I say, lumineers are for minor corrections and mostly for shade corrections. If there's more involved, a cap might be the answer. And if there's missing teeth, probably either a bridge or an implant would be the answer. And as I mentioned in another interview, probably the best way to deal with a missing tooth is an implant and a crown.
Well, all right. Well, thanks a lot, Dr. Lemoncelli.
You're welcome.